Long ago in Canaan, lived a boy named Ibrahim. He is smart young and likes to question everything. Most of the people he knew worshipped idols, but not Ibrahim. These people have forgotten the message conveyed by the prophets Adam, Nuhud, and Saleh. Instead of Allah, instead of worshipping Allah, they worshipped idols. Ibrahim told his father that he forgotten people should not worshipping they made themselves. His father was angry and told him not to say everything more about idols. Ibrahim decided he had to show the people that they were wrong. Then Ibrahim forgotten of a plan. What is plan?
He sneaked into a place where all the status worker. With an axe, Ibrahim beheaded all the heads of the idol expert when idol. Ibrahim left the biggest one. In the morning, people were angry and upset about what happened. They believed Ibrahim was the perpetrator. They grabbed in the square and asked him if he was really the culprit. Maybe you can ask this big statue. Maybe he now who is famous for an offness, said Ibrahim, pointing to the biggest idol. But of course, the idol called that, and people now is just a rock. Ibrahim said, and asked where you were worshiping a rock. The people became every man were angry.
They started collecting wood to make a fire. They wanted to burn Ibrahim alive. They made a big bonfire and laid Ibrahim on it. Everyone comes to watch. They then lit the wood in fire ranged and the grave hanger and hanger. People step back to avoid the head on fire. Ibrahim was a good person. He believed in Allah, so Allah protected him. Allah did not let the fire harm him. When the same did dumb people call believe what they were saying. They say that Ibrahim was still alive and the fire don't need hurt at all. The all need is was a miracle and some of them knelt down. This extraordinary incident made the belief in Allah. Unfortunately, some of the sons of still don't care. They think Ibrahim is just a magician.
Meanwhile, Namrud, king of Canaan, heard everything about Ibrahim. Namrud went out to talk and ask Ibrahim about Allah. So he called Ibrahim to come to his palace. Oh Ibrahim, who is your God? Said King Canaan, said King Namrud. Allah can do everything. Allah can do anything. He can give life to the head and face first to any creature. Answered Ibrahim. I can do that too. I can do that too. Said King Namrud. He ordered his soldiers to bring 2 men. He ordered 1 Caleb and 1 left alive. Then he said, see, me and Allah are the same. Young Ibrahim, with his intelligence, immediate realized that Namrud was stubborn. Allah raised the sun from the east. If what you say is true, raise the sun from the west. Ibrahim acclaimed. Namrud was shocked, and of course he could not do it. Namrud instead said to Ibrahim, show me that your
God can bring back something that has died. With the almighty power of Allah, the Prophet Ibrahim was able to revive four birds next had fallen off. Because of the arrogance of the King Namrud, he did not wait to acknowledge the greatness of Allah. Allah caused mosquitoes in his country until 400 centuries later, the King of Amarillet died.
Moral message from the story of the Prophet Ibrahim: if you depend on your submission only to Allah, then Allah will have and be sufficient. Goodbye.